time has come for people to decide. Are we Indians part of this country's living culture, or are we just here to supply museums with dead bodies? For over half a century, human remains were displayed at a tourist attraction in Salina, Kansas. When people from the Pawnee Nation decided to protest the Salina burial grounds, they were met with opposition from archaeologists who wanted to study the remains. Through amazing persistence, these people from opposing perspectives worked together to reach a compromise, which ultimately led to the protection of human dignity across the nation. Around 1200 AD, the Upper Republican people hunted and farmed in the Nebraska-Kansas region. The Pawnee, Wichita, and Arikara oral traditions say that these people were their ancestors. Over the course of many years, their dead were laid to rest in a shared cemetery.
It was a community covering several miles, and the people had apparently a common burial ground, which is most unusual. And so there were some 150 to 200 different individuals represented within this burial complex.
Guy and Mabel Whiteford were amateur archaeologists in Salina, Kansas in the 1930s. When human bones were unearthed in a rainstorm in 1936, the landowner asked the Whitefords to study the site. There, they discovered remains of many Upper Republicans, carefully buried with their personal belongings. The Whitefords spent the next 10 years thoroughly documenting and excavating this cemetery. They removed some personal belongings, such as jewelry, tools, and pottery. To fund their work, they opened the site to the public, selling admission for 25 cents. The land was purchased by the Price family in 1937, and they allowed the Whitefords to continue their work while sharing the profits. Because the Prices wished to expand the commercial operation, they promoted the largest prehistoric burial pit in the Middle West. With the hope of increased earnings, the Prices discontinued the excavation and asked the Whitefords to leave. The Prices constructed a new building and curio shop over the burial pit and grew their revenues with the expanded features. Here, 15,000 to 20,000 visitors per year could view 146 human bodies on display in their original burial place at the Salina Indian Burial Pit. The site remained in this condition for the next 50 years. In 1985, an American Indian woman decided to visit the Salina Indian Burial Pit. She was appalled by what she saw, and she shared her concerns with the Haskell Indian Junior College in Lawrence, Kansas. In response, the university held a forum, bringing together people with many differing viewpoints to address the concerns.
They had a big meeting at Haskell and invited all of the archaeologists from the state of Kansas to be there. And I'm afraid, as state archaeologist, I was the target, the center of the target. And it was quite a very, very bad day.
For American Indians, these burials represented their ancestors. The display of these remains caused personal anguish and pain. They believed the grounds should be permanently closed and the remains reburied to restore their dignity and let the spirits rest. The archaeologists, however, held differing views. This site was only one of three in the nation and offered the chance to study an unfamiliar culture. The Kansas State Historical Society had been planning to create a museum that would tell the story of the Upper Republican people. Continuing research, but discontinuing the display of human remains.
Well, we had no other sites like it where you had that number of people all there in one spot that had been excavated and then left in place. So this was a really unusual thing.
I recall Tom Whitty, who was the state archaeologist at that time, had gone out there to look at the remains, and they had various plans about the treatment and care of the remains. And he was, I think, very startled as well to hear the native sensitivities concerning the dead and from real live Indian people concerning their ancestors. And I think he was a bit taken aback, but yet to his credit, he was open to a dialogue on that.
The Pawnee elders hired attorney Walter Echohawk with the Native American Rights Fund to represent their grievances. The fund was established in 1970 as a result of the American Indian Movement. Echohawk was a member of the Pawnee Nation and felt a personal connection to the case. He knew that the outcome of this case would ultimately have repercussions across the nation. How could they stop the looting of American Indian burials? and protect remains and sacred objects. For 3 years, archaeologists and American Indians conducted forums and meetings to address their differing viewpoints on the burial site. Tom Woody led the Salina community, legislators, and Indian leaders on discussion of state acquisition. He fought fervently for the chance to study the grounds, but came to believe that closure was what needed to be done.
We realized that there was a lot of ground between the two. Scientists saw these as scientific artifacts to be studied. And to the native peoples, they were the bones of their ancestors. And eventually the compromise was that we met in the middle.
What did my fellow archaeologists think about it? Well, most of them thought we were traitors. We had given in to the Indians. You know, because archaeologists and skeletons and burials go together. That's our data.
The next step was to convince legislators to pass a bill to close the site, protect all unmarked graves in Kansas, and return all human remains and burial artifacts to the appropriate Indian nation, bringing equality to burial laws. Echo Hawk, Woody, and many others provided testimony to a House committee. Finally, they reached a compromise, resulting in the Treaty of Smoky Hill. With the signing of the treaty, the state purchased the site for $90,000, and the Salina Indian Burial Pit was closed. As part of the compromise, the archaeologists were given 5 weeks to study the remains in a non-destructive manner. When the time period had ended, the individuals would be reburied.
I was one on staff who could identify human remains, and they needed that expertise at the Salina Burial Pit. So I went in with the feeling that I was more of a scientist and I was going to study in an emotionally detached way. That changed as I got involved with the project when I began to realize that these were people.
After the study was complete, members of the Pawnee Nation came from Oklahoma to participate in reburial ceremonies. They said a prayer, returned personal belongings, and placed a medicine bag in the graves. As was tradition, the bodies were covered, men with blankets and women with shawls. The area was then filled with sand and covered with a protective concrete cap. Following the reburial, Pawnee members cooked a feast at the home of Salina residents Harold and Margie Reed. They invited all participants from the reburial ceremony to join them. The unmarked burial statute, groundbreaking in many ways, protected all unmarked graves in Kansas and ensured Native involvement in the process. After the Kansas legislation was adopted, Nebraska passed a similar law. Together, these formed the basis for the Native American Graves Protection and Repatriation Act, or NAGPRA, which Congress passed in 1990. This spurred other states to follow similar guidelines. As part of NAGPRA, the National Museum of the American Indian was established, and museums across the nation began to repatriate remains they were holding in their collections. So far, more than 30,000 remains and 500,000 burial artifacts have been repatriated. Because of these efforts, American society has become more aware of Native cultures and their beliefs. Discussions continue to this day. Who owns the past?
All my own ancestors and my own sensibilities as an individual, and it was also, I thought, very profound in another way, and that was really to see the social change, you know, that occurred there in Kansas that led to a national change in social values, I think, you know, social attitudes on a aspect of our race relations here in the United States. And I thought that was very profound as well. And so I was very glad to be a small part of that.
For over half a century, human remains were displayed at a tourist attraction in Salina, Kansas. When people from the Pawnee Nation decided to protest the Salina burial grounds, they were met with opposition from archaeologists who wanted to study the remains. Through amazing persistence, these people from opposing perspectives worked together to reach a compromise, which ultimately led to the protection of human dignity across the nation.